Okay, so if people are interested in buying Under Armour eyewear, where would they typically find it?
You could certainly go to underarmour.com. You could go to PGA Tour Superstores in your area.
Mm-hmm.
Most of your premier pro shops, Dick's Sporting Goods, Golf Galaxy.
Well, there is a PGA Superstore just down the road from here, so I went there. That place is huge, so I would recommend that as well. But now, so in your website address is, so if people want to purchase direct or just learn a little bit more about the product line?
www.underarmour.com. And the PGA Tour Superstore down the road from you, they're a great partner of ours, and there's a great selection of glasses in that store.
Oh, well, like I said, I've been wearing mine now for a while. I really enjoy wearing them. In the driving, work great. And when I say driving, I mean off the first tee or behind the wheel. So either or, it's a great product. And I don't say that easily because, trust me, I've got about 50 pairs of glasses at home. So the fact that I've been wearing these regularly, it really says a lot for this product. So I recommend it. And I think that anybody who's listening ought to go check that out.
Well, thank you very much. It's good to see you at the show. I hope you enjoy the Octanes, and let's stay in touch.
Will do, and I'm sure I'll see you at the show again next year. I've been doing it now for 20 years. How long have you been doing it?
Just about that long.
There you go. A couple of veterans, seasoned veterans, right?
Correct.
All right. Well, thank you so much, Tom, for calling in. We really appreciate it.
Thank you. Have a good weekend.
Thank you. You too. All right. So that was Tom Cox, VP of Sales for Under Armour Eyewear. What we're going to do is take one more quick break, and we will be back with more of the Golf and Travel Show. Stay tuned.
Cinderella story, out of nowhere, a former greenskeeper now about to become the Masters champion.
It looks like I'm a wreck. It's in the hole!
I rap fly, call me Chocolate Thunder, and I got good two gold, four strokes under. Get out the way if you want to go play, because I give up my all.
And we are back. Time for one more message from our sponsor, Labor Finders. If your business needs industrial workers, or if you're looking for work, you got to call Labor Finders. Labor Finders places for temporary or temporary to hire opportunities for skilled, semi-skilled, or general labor positions, such as plumbers, electricians, concrete workers, forklift operators, hospitality, office clerical, and so much more. Labor Finders has almost 200 offices nationwide. Near here in Boca Raton, they have offices in Homestead, Miami, Fort Lauderdale, West Palm Beach, and in Jupiter. If you need legal, insured workers, or if you're looking for work, call Labor Finders toll-free at 800-864-7749. That's 800-864-7749, or visit laborfinders.com. And this is a time when we kind of switch gears and move over to the travel side of the world and let you know what's going on, the good, the bad, the ugly, so we can give you some tips so that you don't get in trouble and you do the right stuff. And the industry that we often cover, of course, is the airline industry, because you need them to get to where you need to go. And this past week, personally, I kind of felt some pain from the airline industry, not me, but my guests who came in for my wedding, my daughter's wedding. Many of them got stranded by United Airlines, whose IT system went down. The latest in a rash of issues in the past year or so, there have been, Delta, Southwest, British Airways, they've all had it. And you kind of wonder in today's world why there's no redundancy and backup, that system can go down like that and strand, you know, flyers all across the country, if not all across the world. United said that a very, very small number of delays occurred. I think that they minimized it just a little bit. And to be honest with you, weather also then came into play, too. There was some weather around, so we had people who their flights were canceled on American as well as United. So I don't know. They got to figure this out. It's just not right. On the good side, the airline that typically is my favorite, Southwest, they just added a route that's of interest to me. It's a little bit too late for my purposes, but they are now going to be flying from San Diego to Los Cabos in Mexico. The first international destination for them out of San Diego. And when I was out there in San Diego, I was kind of looking. I was out there during the week for work, and I was looking for a place that I could kind of sneak away and add on a little weekend escape. And Cabos is a place I wanted to go to because you can't really get there easily from Florida. So I figured, oh, I'm all the way out there in San Diego. This should be easy. Well, no, still wasn't easy. I would have had to have flown up to Los Angeles to then go back south to Mexico. And the amount of time and the money, and it was too expensive, too time consuming, so I didn't do it. So I kind of wish that Southwest had made this announcement sooner rather than later. But what are you going to do? Another topic that I like to talk about quite a bit because I visit there very, very frequently is Las Vegas. And there's never a shortage of news for Las Vegas. And today is no different than any other week. A story that I saw actually that came out a couple of weeks ago, it seems that there is a test going on in downtown Vegas right now on the Fremont Street area, the entertainment district down there where a lot of partying is going on. They now have a electric shuttle to take people around. But the cool part about it is it's driverless. So these driverless cars and shuttles are not just a news story anymore. They actually they're happening. There is a human inside it. It has a computer monitor, but there's no steering wheel. There's no brake pedals. The passengers push a button at a marked stop to board it. And the shuttle uses GPS and electronic curb sensors and other technology. It doesn't... I don't know. It has a range of about 90 miles on each charge and top speed at 25 miles per hour, although they're keeping it at about 15 during this trial. And it's just sounds pretty cool. If anybody steps in front of it, a person, a dog or anything, obviously it stops, which is pretty cool. So if you're in Las Vegas down by Fremont Street and you've had a few drinks and the shuttle comes and you see that nobody is driving it, don't be alarmed. It's supposed to be that way. And speaking of Las Vegas, there's never a shortage of people going there. Yet again, they've set another record for visitors for 2016. The numbers came in, and it seems that in 2016, almost 43 million people visited, up from a little over 42. So, not a huge increase, but it seems that every year it keeps going up and up. And when you're out there, it's no surprise because you see all the people that are out there in the crowds and, the new construction, new hotels, new restaurants. It just never stops. So they do believe that, 2017 is projected to be another record breaking year. And, I'm not surprised by that. So I will be getting out there briefly for just dinner, actually, taking my wife for Valentine's dinner to Las Vegas. Don't ask me why. It's a long story, but we're actually going to go out there just for dinner. So that should be interesting. Hey, you got to do something special for your wife every once in a while, especially on Valentine's Day. Another thing that I saw in the news, which is something that I had seen with my own two eyes, but I didn't get a chance to talk about it. And this kind of takes me back to my days in New York City where, I lived in New York City for a long time. I worked there. And one of my favorite places for a inexpensive lunch treat was a place called Papaya King. And they're famous for their papaya drinks, which they said were supposed to be extremely healthy for your digestive tract. It was kind of like a smoothie. Think like Orange Julius, but instead of orange, papaya. And it seems that the pectins that are inside papaya are very, very good for your digestion. And so you know, they had these drinks, but they also were very famous for their hot dogs. And their saying that they always used was that it's tastier than filet mignon. And, you know, that might be a bit of a stretch, but it was an excellent hot dog. And this place opened up about 85 years ago on the corner of 86th and 3rd in New York. Originally, a Greek immigrant by the name of Gus Poulos started it. And, you know, they did try and open up in a couple of other places over the years. Not much, but they had a place in Upper Darby, Pennsylvania. So it's on the outskirts, I guess, of Philly. A place in Milford, Connecticut, as well, and even a place on Long Island at a food court somewhere. But they never really, you know, started to spread like other fast food chains have. But recently they opened up right across the street from the Hard Rock Hotel in Las Vegas. And it's quite, it's getting a lot of publicity out there. I guess obviously there's a lot of New Yorkers and people that have a fond memory of this, perhaps from their childhood or their youth like myself. And when I saw this story, it just reminded me that I wanted to let everybody know. They actually, it originally it was called Hawaiian Tropical Drinks. They changed it to Papaya King in the 1960s. But people like Julia Child and Martha Stewart actually sung its praises. So, you know, for a hot dog joint to get praises from somebody like a Julia Child or a Martha Stewart, they must be doing something right. So, you know, when you go out to Las Vegas, especially if you're on the Strip, to find good places to eat and not to drop a fortune on your dinner is not easy. So it's always nice. Excuse me. It's always nice to have a place where you can go and you can grab a, you know, an inexpensive meal. So I recommend that if you're out there in Vegas to give Papaya King a try. What I'd like to do now is I got a bunch of Dan's deals. I usually save them for the last segment, and we got just a couple of minutes before the last segment. But because I got a plethora of deals, perhaps what I will do is I'll dig into them before our last break, and then I can continue with the rest of them. And what I typically like to do is I kind of like to work my way from the closest to the furthest. And my geography isn't always perfect, especially if, you know, there's two places that are kind of far away and I'm not sure which one is further. So it's not always a perfect science. But this first deal I definitely know is the closest. And it is a town that I enjoy visiting, a hotel that I'm familiar with, although I haven't stayed there. It's the location that I really think is a perfect location. And this would be in Naples. And by the way, all of these deals, like I usually find them on TravelZoo.com. So that's how you're going to find these deals. That's where you got to go look for them, TravelZoo.com. So this is a hotel deal called the hotel is the Bayfront Inn on Fifth Avenue. It's at the very beginning of Fifth Avenue, which is the really cool shopping district street in downtown Naples. The nice restaurants, the fancy shops are all there. And you have to understand that Naples is, especially in season, an extremely expensive place. Even in off season, you know, the prices come down, but some of the fancier places are quite expensive. This is, I wouldn't call it a fancy hotel. It's a nice hotel, but it's not fancy. But its location is perfect right there on Fifth. It's on the bay. That's why it's called the Bayfront Inn. And you can walk to all of the shops and all the restaurants. So the convenience is really excellent. And depending upon how long you wait until the peak season is over, so the least expensive rooms begin on April 13th and run through September 30th. And you can get for just $89 a city view room or $109 a bay view room, which is really inexpensive for Naples. And if you want to go a little bit sooner, like now through March, it's $149 for a city view room and $169 for a bay view room. Still very inexpensive. These prices include children under 17 for free. It's two guests in a room. You also get two welcome drinks. and if you're traveling during the summer months, the off season, April through September, you get an hour-long kayak rental as well. So $89, you know, starting at, that you just can't beat that. There's also free parking and free Wi-Fi. And just the parking alone at the upscale places can cost you an arm and a leg. So almost as much as the room costs. So I do recommend that. Naples is just a really lovely place. Some of those restaurants there on Fifth are excellent. And the shopping is great, too. And that's another thing. The shopping in peak season, those shops are very, very expensive. But there's all sorts of sidewalk sales that start breaking out once the off-season hits. And you can pick up some very, very nice designer clothing at a pittance of their regular price if you buy it right. And, of course, you know, around here in Florida, it's summer all year long. So, you know, the stuff that they're clearing out because it's off-season, well, it's always the same season here. So it's a deal that I recommend. So travelzoo.com is where you're going to find that. So I got a bunch more deals for you. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to catch my breath so that I don't cough too much more before the show is over. So give me a chance to catch my breath, and we'll be back with more of Dan's deals for you right after the break. Stay tuned for more of the Golf and Travel Show. And we are back. And as I promised you, we'll take a tour of the world starting from Florida, and pretty soon we'll be far away. Next up is a place that everybody knows I'm also quite familiar with because I talk about it all the time. It's back in my hometown, New York. And I do get to visit family, friends, typically on Long Island. But whenever I do go up there, I also would like to spend a little bit of time in the city if I can. And obviously, no surprise to anybody, hotels in New York City are ridiculously expensive. And anytime that you can find a good deal in New York on a hotel, my advice is to grab it. And, you know, I just spoken about Hilton, had my, you know, party there. And, the Hiltons are typically consistent. And here's a Hilton that is near the fashion district. It's called the New York City Chelsea Hilton. So you're going to be near Penn Station if you want to take a train out to Long Island, not too far from Times Square, Broadway, Theater District, lots of restaurants, etc. So it's a good area to be able to stay in. And right now, hotels, you know, you easily could be spending $200-$300 a night in that neighborhood for a halfway decent hotel. And right now, for as little as $99 a night, you could stay at a Hilton. And keep in mind that, you know, when you stay at a Hilton, you know, hopefully you'll be able to be one of their honors members and take advantage of all the perks that comes with it. So this deal, you do have to book by January 30th. So I advise you to not wait too long. And they got some great amenities there. They got a bar and they got a gym and a fitness center. They got a restaurant. So, you know, everything you would expect in a Hilton except the price, because trust me, you don't pay $99 for a full-fledged Hilton very often anywhere. And this is for now, into March, and this includes weekends as well. So obviously somebody like myself, if I'm going to head up to New York for a little getaway, catch some shows or whatnot, chances are it's going to include a weekend. So, $99, really a no-brainer. That's for a standard king room, but you could also upgrade to a higher floor where you get away from some of that noise and you might get a much better view for just $10 more. So that's just crazy. It's rated 4 stars, this particular Hilton, so I feel comfortable recommending it. You're less than a 15-minute walk from Madison Square Garden, the Empire State Building. And it's being that it's near the fashion district, that's the theme of the hotel. Everything is all about, high-end fashion. So, it's pretty cool. But hurry up, January 30th, and that deal will expire. Traveling a little bit further, or maybe not from Florida, I don't know. If you're looking to get away to Mexico, and if you're looking for a, all-inclusive, which can be a really good value, especially if you do like to eat a lot and drink a lot, then it can be a great value. We're talking about the Riviera Maya. and a 4-star resort with a suite upgrade. This includes airfare from Miami. And this is found on Travelzoo through Vacation Express. And again, so this is all inclusive, 4 stars. I'm looking at a picture, beautiful infinity pool right on the ocean, a gorgeous beach. You know, you want to be here, trust me. And we're talking about a price of only $549 per person, airfare, hotel, alcohol, food, you name it. It's 3 nights and an upgraded junior suite. And this hotel is called the El Cid Spa and Beach Resort. So obviously there's a spa. The spas are always extra, even in an all-inclusive. But needless to say, you're still not going to pay as much here as you would at many resorts in the States, for instance. And, hey, alcohol, you know, you can't go wrong. They have departures in April and May. You can also get departures in February, March, and June, and it just costs a little bit more. This one you have to book by February 3rd, so you have a little bit of time, but I never would wait too many days. You know, if you know today, don't wait until February 3rd, because sometimes the dates that you're looking for may just sell out. So, and Vacation Express, they got a pretty good reputation. They've been doing these kinds of trips for over 25 years, so I would not hesitate to go and check them out on Travelzoo. We also talk in the past few months a lot about trips to Europe, because there are some incredible deals to Europe. So if you would like to go to London, here is a package from Fort Lauderdale. And we're talking about spring or fall dates. And there's a lot of dates available. And starting at $699 per person, which typically is about what just airfare alone is, you can get 4 nights in London, nonstop flights, city center hotel, breakfast included. Sounds like a pretty good deal to me, $699. So these flights are on Norwegian Air, and they're flying those 787 Dreamliners. So, you know, it's a very comfortable flight. They have increased humidity, better cabin pressure, noise reduction, ambient lighting. So this is a brand new plane. And keep in mind, too, that right now the dollar is extremely strong against the pound. So once you get there, your dollar is going to go much further. And if you want to, you can add on a 2-night stay in another European city starting at $199 additional per person. Some choices include Paris, Prague, Edinburgh, Barcelona, or Dublin. So this is, again, on TravelZoo.com through a packager called Fleetway. And it's, let's see, you can choose in London between places such as the London Kensington, which is only a metro stop from the High Street Shops, or the Novotel London West, which is a 10-minute drive from Kensington Palace, or the Doubletree by Hilton London Chelsea, which is a 2-minute walk from King's Road. This you have to book by February 10th to take advantage of it. But again, I would not wait until the last minute. All of those hotels, by the way, are considered 4-star hotels. Keep in mind that when you are looking at the stars and the ratings, sometimes Europe or other places in the world are not quite the same as here. So a 4-star in the States might be, when you're in Europe, they say it's 4 stars, it might be kind of the equivalent of a 3-star or something. So keep that in mind. But still, that is a, you know, nice hotels, decent locations, incredible price. While we're talking about Europe, here's another one that seems to be a really good deal to places that I have been to. A few of them anyway, and one I have not. We're talking about Paris, Bruges, and Amsterdam. I've been to Paris. I've been to Bruges. I'm trying to get to Amsterdam desperately. Looking at a picture right now of all of the tulips in bloom. And again, this is on Travelzoo. And 6 nights we're talking about, and this includes flights as well. 6 nights accommodation, sightseeing, entrance fees, guide services, all ground transportation, daily breakfast, 2 dinners with wine, hotel porterage, excuse me, sightseeing such as cruising the famed canals in Amsterdam and in Volendam. You get to visit a cheese farm and see a working windmill. Bruges, they say, is like a Gothic fairy tale with medieval churches and cobble streets and canals, and I can vouch for that. The beer, if you're a beer lover, Bruges is where you need to go for beer. And, of course, in Paris, you get to the Latin Quarter, the Champs-Élysées, great for strolling. But, of course, in the warmer months, that's a good time to take your little stroll. They've got departures in April, in May, June, August, September, and October. The price of $14.99 is from New York City departures. You can also tack on extra nights before and after if you choose. The hotel is a 4-star Renaissance in Amsterdam for 2 nights, which is a 10-minute walk from Dam Square. The Novotel Bruges Centrum in Bruges for 1 night with an outdoor pool and a garden terrace. And the 4-star Hotel Novotel Paris in Montparnasse, 3 nights, a rooftop terrace, sweeping views of the city, including the Eiffel Tower. You got to book this by February 3rd if you want to get in. It's a savings of as much as $2,000 compared to some other similar packages. This is through a provider called Gate One. But again, you will find it on Travelzoo, February 3rd. Don't wait until the last minute. And I got one more. And this one, of course, goes the furthest of all. I'm pretty sure of that. And this is yachting in Bali. 7 nights sailing with $900 in credits on Star Clippers. And you got to get your way there. This does not include airfare. But we're talking about yachting in Bali for $899 per person. But it includes $500 in onboard credit per cabin for drinks and spa services. And it does provide a $400 air credit per person that if you book it together, you can use that credit. And airfare these days is inexpensive, so $400 will go a long way. We're talking about a 7-night cruise on the Star Clipper. It's a small ship. It only holds about 200 people. They've got departures in May, July, August, and September. Yeah, you could do worse. This also is part of a larger sale. If you'd like to go for 10 or 11 nights, you got to book this again by February 3rd. Port charges and taxes are an additional $240 per person, but this still is an incredible deal. So I recommend going to Bali. I have not gone there myself, and I would love to. All right, what we are going to do is remind everybody to go to facebook.com/thegolfandtravelshow so you can find out who our guests are going to be coming up. I want to thank Tom Cox, the VP of Sales for Under Armour Eyewear. He's the guy that makes me look good. You can look good, too, by getting yourself a pair of Under Armour. And what we are going to do is we will be back same time, same place next week with some more cool guests and lots of news, and we'll be talking about more of the golf products that have been introduced at the show. So that you can go out there, hit them straight, have a good time, and we'll talk to you about it all next week. So stay tuned then for more of the Golf and Travel Show.
You have been listening to the Golf and Travel Show, hosted by Dan Chu. Heard live every Friday, 7 to 8 p.m. on 1470 WWNN, and replayed every Sunday from 6 to 7 p.m. on 740 AM WSBR. Visit the show on Facebook and tune in next week. If you are in South Florida or traveling the world, hit them straight. The opinions expressed on the following sponsor program are strictly those of the host, guests, and callers, and not necessarily those of this station, its staff, management, or sponsors.
Peek-a-boo. Peek-a-boo. Smile.
Smile, buddy.
Come on, smile. Oh, honey, he's still not smiling.
Maybe he's not a smiler.
Yeah, maybe he's just not a happy baby.
Maybe he's just being a boy. You know how boys are.
Or maybe he's teething. Oh, poor baby. I think his gums hurt.
Maybe he's just tired.
Or maybe his tummy hurts. He didn't eat that much.
Maybe he's not ticklish.
You think maybe he's scared of the dog?
Maybe he'll outgrow it. Maybe it's a phase. Maybe he just doesn't like smiling.
Maybe he has autism, and we can definitely do something to help.
Maybe is all you need to find out more about autism. No big, joyful smiles by 6 months is one early sign. Learn the others at autismspeaks.org/signs or see a doctor today for an autism screening. The sooner it's diagnosed, the better. And it can make a lifetime of difference. Brought to you by Autism Speaks and the Ad Council.
Hi, I'm Judith Light. So there you are. It's flu season and you're over 65 like me. You're having another busy year. So much to do, so many roles in life to play. But you feel like you might be forgetting something serious. Your annual flu shot. And